If you were desperate to spend more time with the people you love, would you consider going to the other side of the world to achieve it? Even if that meant risking everything you know and care about in the UK. Years working away from home has taken a heavy toll on John Woodland's family life.
I understood why he had to go away. It was just horrible.
He's desperate for more time with them and believes Australia's the answer.
This is my dream, Mrs. Love. Just like them, be home every single day, spend time with you.
But with daughter Chloe not wanting to move...
It's quite scary to be in like a completely different country, the other side of the world.
And wife Kerry unwilling to leave her at home.
I don't physically feel that I could leave her in this country and move over with just me and John.
Will a trial week down under be enough to convince the whole family to make the move? Australia offers the chance of an ideal family life to more than 35,000 Brits who emigrate there every year. With its mild climate and beautiful beaches, it's easy to see why. But it doesn't work out for everyone, and for many, the dream ends up back where it started. John Woodland is missing out on family life, and he's convinced that a move down under would give him the time he desperately needs with his wife and daughter. Ahead of him lies just 1 week to persuade them that to move to Australia is worth giving up their lives in the UK. After a lengthy delay in London, the Woodlands touched down in Perth much later than scheduled. It's been more than 24 hours since they left home, and the marathon journey of over 10,000 miles has had an impact.
Our flight was very, very long. It was very, very tiring.
They may be worn out, but they're raring to go.
Now we're here, you know, it's not just talking and maybe, it's going to be making our minds up time. Just to see really what Australia's got to offer and what my dad has been bragging about. And if it is for me really.
I'm quite excited about the whole thing at the moment, so let the adventure begin, I say.
Ahead is a week that could change their lives forever. The Woodlands are from Gwent in South Wales. They are John, Kerry and daughter Chloe, who's 19. Australia has been on John's mind since he visited 17 years ago on a posting with the army.
I thought, what a beautiful country. So laid back, so relaxed.
When John returned from Australia, he was really excited about what he'd experienced out there. And for a long while after that, he did say, you know, it's something that we should perhaps think about in the future.
John was an HGV driver in the army. When he left the forces, a lack of local jobs left him no choice but to carry on with that career. But all the time on the road has meant long spells away from home.
I've had sole responsibility for Chloe's, bringing Chloe up, for looking after the house, for doing everything really, you know, that normally a family would do together. I've done everything alone. It does make you a little bit resentful of the other person for leaving you in that situation, but at the same time, you are aware that it's a necessity.
Providing for his family meant John completely missed out on Chloe's childhood.
Not being able to see him through the week. Not, like, him being able to see me grow up. Be who I am today, really.
It's a painful situation the whole family feel can't go on any longer. Desperate for change, John thinks a move down under could be the answer.
A perfect outcome in Australia would be to find a job where I am working 6 till 4 or 4 till 6, whatever hours it is, but being home every single day to spend more time with my family, going for walks, take my wife to the pub for a drink. That's what I want to do.
Both John and Kerry feel Australia could offer Chloe a much better future.
I work in a chip shop, I go to college and I do nail technology.
I would like her to experience more out of life than living in a small town and spending all her days here.
It's the opportunities which she could have over there.
And her children, isn't it?
And her children, and to give her those those opportunities, really.
But while Chloe can see some appeal in moving far from home, it would mean saying goodbye to her boyfriend.
I've been with Sam for around a year now. Don't really want to lose him.
Kerry knows that without her daughter agreeing to a move, John's dream could disappear.
If Chloe decided that she wouldn't want to live in Australia, I think that the whole idea really would just be forgotten, because I don't physically feel that I could leave her in this country and move over with just me and John.
And I do feel a bit pressured into going a bit. Like, if I don't go, what will happen to my family, really?
Saying goodbye to loved ones could also be a massive sticking point for Kerry.
Oh, the prospect of leaving my family and friends is huge for me.
But despite her emotional ties to the UK, Kerry realises something has to give, and John believes they could have a much better lifestyle in Australia.
I can't see ourselves sort of carrying on as we are now forever. I think that would just be sort of, we would be silly to do that, and it would just be a waste.
It's been a dream of mine for a long, long time, just to spend some quality time with Kerry. She's missed so much, and I've missed so much of not being with her.
The Woodlands are at crisis point. John's job is wrecking family life, and he's convinced Australia offers a better future. Ahead of him is just 1 week to convince Chloe and Kerry that his dream is worth giving up the close ties they have in the UK. Then the family will face the biggest decision of their lives, whether to stay in the UK or make the move down under, a permanent one. The Woodlands are spending their trial week in Perth. It's the country's fastest growing major city, and with less than 5% unemployment, it's a popular destination for new arrivals seeking a fresh start down under. It's late and dark as the family arrive at their temporary home. Hopefully, it won't disappoint.
What a good day, isn't it?
Yeah, I like the open plan. I like the kitchen and the living area all together.
It's quite a big tally, isn't it?
John settles in right away.
Put the kettle on, love.
But Chloe's not so keen.
Do you like it?
No. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Why? It's nice. I just don't think it's nothing compared to where we go back home.
No.
Perhaps not the start John was hoping for, but what they can see outside looks a bit more promising.
Oh, this is nice, John.
Is it?
We're going to go a glass roof.
Massive, aren't you?
I know. It's quite secluded, isn't it, back?
As everyone settles into their temporary base, Kerry knows her husband's already set on a move.
Even now, on the first day, just starting off, I think that John is already sold on the idea. I think that if you asked him to vote now, he would say Australia, without even having a good look round.
But if John's to get the whole family to emigrate to the other side of the world, he'll have to work hard at convincing Chloe to buy into his dream.
It's quite scary to be in like a completely different country, the other side of the world. And knowing that this is somewhere that I could potentially be living.
Hopefully the coming week will be enough to unite the family once and for all.
This could give us an opportunity of a lifetime. But at the end of the day, I won't force my wife or my daughter to do something they wouldn't want to do.
The whole point of coming is to hopefully make a decision that we all agree on. But obviously if that doesn't happen, then we are back to the drawing board.
Back in the UK, home for the Woodlands is this £80,000 three-bedroom terrace house in Tredegar in Gwent, South Wales.
The area is very pretty. We have a lot of countryside and mountains. And I feel that if we moved to Australia, we would probably like to live in one of the suburbs. We'd like that nice community feel that we have here in Tredegar.
Just like meet people and has the good old barbecue stuff and things like that, isn't it, really?
I'd like just a modest property, really. I mean, obviously, I think everyone's dream is to have a big house, but I think that that's less important. I think the most important thing for us is just having a base that you can call home. Obviously, a nice house. I mean, finances are dependent. And I know that Chloe would love to have a pool, but I think the most important thing is that it's just a family home and just somewhere that you're happy.
The Woodlands would rent if they moved down under. We'll show them three different properties based on what they can afford, their ideal home, and something in between. Only after seeing what's on offer will they find out how much each one costs. The first property is in the suburb of Trinity, a fast-growing seaside town 35 minutes drive north of Perth city centre. with every home just a stroll away from Western Australia's beautiful coastline and the community feel the Woodlands are looking for, this area should be just the ticket. Will this modern three-bedroom show home get the house hunting off to a good start?
Oh, look at that. It's nice, that, isn't it?
Oh, it's lovely flooring.
Absolutely. You like it, Gary?
It's lovely.
Wow.
Ours is lovely, Chloe.
This is really nice.
Isn't it?
This would be mine.
This would be your room.
Would it really?
Yeah.
It's looking good so far.
There you are, Chloe. There's your wardrobe.
I know.
Oh, man.
Chloe's always wanted a walk-in wardrobe.
Oh, yeah. My wardrobe's too small. I can't see all my clothes back on. Oh, this is amazing.
Every girl's dream, Chloe. And Kerry's loving the open plan design.
This is lovely.
This is really nice.
Isn't it?
And I quite like all the glass, that the room is really light and airy. Feels nice and sunny and bright.
Will outdoors get as positive a response?
It's not a very big garden, okay, is it?
You've got the beach literally opposite.
Yeah.
You have got the outside space, so you wouldn't be just confined to your garden.
Isn't John the one supposed to be doing the hard sell, Kerry?
So I think it's plenty big enough for our needs.
And Chloe is very clear what her needs are.
And we could fit a hot tub down below too.
So this is, I assume, like a family bathroom.
That's quite a big shower.
Which is plenty big enough. It's a general size shower. Right, Chloe, I think this one might be your room after all.
The artwork's okay. They're quite strange, aren't they?
Funny eyes.
Overall, the house is very nice.
I really like this house. I think it's a lot better than our house back home.
It's plenty big enough for the three of us.
John should be pleased. It's a really positive start to the day. But will this house be within their £1,250 a month rental budget?
Shall we have a look?
Shall we? Go ahead,
Chloe.
£1,210
a month.
That's about what we planned on, really.
That's not too bad at all. That would be manageable, I think.
If we could afford a house like this, or we could get a house like this on that sort of money, if we can get the jobs over here, then.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Brilliant. Yeah. Really pleased with that price.
We won you over yet, Chloe?
A little.
Yes.
The next property is in Tapping, 20 miles north of Perth. It's a quiet residential area, 5 minutes from the amenities of the nearby town of Joondalup and close to the beach. Will this stylish four-bedroom family home win the Woodlands' approval?
This is like a little study. Can you imagine this nice street where you get to meet your neighbours? You know, everyone's quite close by. What? I quite like the little bit of grass area at the front, the little sort of yard area.
That could mean the location's right, and John may have spotted another upside.
That's not going to be a walk-in wardrobe, is it?
Can I have a look?
Shockers. Go on then. That's nice.
That's lovely. It's huge, Chloe.
That's ticked one box.
And then you've got the shower, the ensuite.
This is nice.
This is a good size room, sitting room.
Oh, this is a living, is it?
It is nice and cosy. You can imagine coming home from work and just having a nice relaxing night, couldn't you? Just watching TV in here.
Kerry's ready to move in and the tour has hardly begun.
Oh man. This is lovely.
Well, what can you say?
Yeah, this is probably definitely up to our price range, I think.
Absolutely massive.
This is
wow, isn't it?
Yeah, there's no other word for it, so you can't explain. It's absolutely beautiful.
You'd never find anything like this back home.
No.
This house may have a lot going for it, but there's one feature Kerry's not too keen on.
The only thing I don't like about this room is the pool table in the middle. It's not, you know, it's not something that you'd expect in your sort of front room.
John doesn't mind.
No, I think that's all right.
You like it? Yeah, you don't
that
mind
can stay,
it?
That yeah, can stay there, little Chloe.
Yeah, we like that.
It'll stay there quite easily, yeah.
It's all going swimmingly well until Chloe spots a problem.
It's tiny.
It's a massive walk-in room, now.
Practical Kerry's got a suggestion.
But you wouldn't need winter clothes in Australia, so you wouldn't need as much space.
No.
Not sure Chloe's buying that. And the wardrobe's not the only thing on the dinky side.
This is small and
It's big enough for everything that you need.
Yeah, this is the main bathroom, is it?
And you've got such big rooms everywhere else, and you just put the bathroom into a tiny little space.
But there's one outdoor feature already installed which could bring Chloe round.
It's just, you know, luxury, isn't it, to have a hot tub sat in the garden there?
I like the garden, but I just
don't get the right feel
for
it.
Like the house itself.
You wouldn't feel comfortable?
No, I think it's a lovely house. I just don't think it's
not for you.
Not for me, no.
Even with the hot tub, this house just isn't wowing Chloe. But John and Kerry could see themselves living here.
I think this house is lovely. I think it's got a lovely size. It's got plenty of bedrooms if people come to stay.
It is a nice house. I wouldn't have any qualms of living here.
But is it somewhere they could afford to call home on their £1,250 rental budget?
What do you reckon?
I don't know. No idea.
Cheaper than the last place,
no, dear? Probably a lot more expensive.
That's almost £200 a month over budget. But...
Not much dearer.
I was expecting this to be hugely, if not double, the last one. I'm really shocked and really pleased because that's still affordable for us.
It's good price, isn't it?
But you still don't like the house.
I still don't like the house.
With two properties down, the pressure's on to find somewhere the whole family would move around the world for. Could the final house be the dream home? It's also in the Tapping area. With four bedrooms, this house could offer the space and comfort they want. But will the price fit the Woodlands budget?
It's a nice little garden, John.
It is,
a little bit of a driveway.
It's quite a nice estate,
garage.
First impressions are good. What about the interior?
Oh, it's nice, John, isn't it? That's lovely, isn't there?
I do like this, yeah.
I like the way it's quite private as well, the low, not being unlocked.
No, that's true.
Lovely big storage cupboards. They are lovely, the decorators are really nice, aren't they?
They are nice.
And again, you've got the nice wardrobes, you're saving all the space.
They may be nice, but they're not walk-in yet.
I've decided anyway, what I'd do is get rid of the doors, then put a wall there so I could have a walk-in wardrobe then.
Really?
Oh, it's nice and big.
The bathroom's an improvement on the last property.
Do you think this is bigger?
Yeah, a lot bigger.
Yeah.
Do you think
this seems bigger?
It's a lot spacious, isn't it?
Oh dear me.
Oh, this is nice, isn't it? Lovely.
Why have you always got walk-in wardrobes and I haven't got either?
That's it's not as big as
it's not as big as the last one, is it? But it's plenty big enough for my stuff.
Yeah.
It's lovely, no.
You can have a shelf, John.
That's good of you, Kerry.
I'm
watching you. It's a nice size though, isn't it?
Don't need it, Ken.
There's yours.
You got me
up. How happy he is.
I saw it, don't I?
That's more like it. And the master bedroom's got another attractive feature.
Got our own
private
porch.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really nice.
Kerry's sitting down with Roger this morning.
But there might be a slight problem.
I might have to get rid of the plants or trim them back a little bit.
Because you're scared of spiders.
Scared of the spiders.
What? A big Welshman like you, John?
Oh, this is lovely. Look at this, John. This is huge.
Oh, this is nice.
This is huge. It's almost like two separate living areas, three separate living areas.
It's nice, the kitchen.
And the kitchen is absolutely massive.
And there's an outdoor feature that should appeal to everyone.
Oh, what's that there?
Nice big fridge. Oh, what a pool. It's nice, isn't it?
This is
lovely,
really nice.
Isn't it? Again, it's undercover, which is perfect. You even got sides, John, that you can pull down.
Have the Woodlands found their dream home?
Yeah, this is what I've had in mind, Kerr.
This would be living the dream, wouldn't it?
It would be.
It does make you see, doesn't it, what the opportunities could be.
I really like this house.
Stunning.
Amazing, yeah.
Chloe's reaction is just the response John was hoping for.
It's everything I would like if I moved to Australia.
I actually haven't got anything negative to say about it.
Good God.
No, I know.
It looks like this house is a big hit with everyone, but will the price be on the right side of their £1,250 a month budget?
Do you reckon it'll be more or less?
Oh, definitely more.
Do you think so?
Yeah,
I think it might be even.
No, I think it's a lot more expensive. I think it's probably something you'd have to look at, sort of, you know, aiming for later on down the line. I don't think it's something you could afford at this point.
Are you ready?
Go on then.
Da-na-na-na.
That's more than £400 over budget.
Yeah. 1667.
Yeah, it's quite high.
But Kerry's cautiously optimistic.
Surprisingly, it's cheaper than I thought it would be. I think it'd be a lot more than that. Definitely. And I think that would be probably doable once you're sort of established in jobs, you know, three of us working.
I wouldn't want second best. So I would work hard and then get somewhere else, I would.
So what have the Woodlands made of Perth properties? The first house was within budget, but the size of the garden let it down. Property number two was somewhere Kerry and John could call home, but Chloe wasn't convinced. The final house had the wow factor and a price tag to match, but if the Woodlands can find the right jobs, it could be affordable. So have they seen enough to persuade them to give up their home in the UK?
Based on the properties we've seen today, we are voting for...
Australia. Why did you vote Australia?
Because I think the houses over here are a lot better than the ones in the UK.
I'm the same. I don't think you can deny the fact that the houses are lovely.
And I've seen a house free. That just nailed it for me.
Yeah. Australia.
Absolutely. Well done, girl.
It's the perfect start for John. With Kerry and Chloe both voting for Australia, his dream has taken a huge step forward. Their ideal home will come at a cost, so if the move down under is to happen, it's crucial that John and Kerry find the jobs to fund it. Kerry's the main visa applicant. Back in the UK, she's an experienced midwife.
I've been a midwife for 7 years. I've enjoyed the job, even though it can be very, very stressful and demanding. I do feel very settled here and very supported and with my colleagues. And I do feel that going to a new trust and a new area, a new country, would be quite daunting.
We've arranged for Kerry to spend some time at June Dulup Health Campus, a local private hospital with a brand new maternity wing.
I'm a little bit nervous about this today, just going into sort of an environment that I'm not familiar with, but also excited to find out what the possibilities could be for me in the future.
Hopefully Chris, a fellow midwife who moved from the UK, can put Kerry at ease about the move.
I came about 10 years ago, Kerry. Quite daunting when you come initially. I left such a fabulous crowd of girls in the UK and I thought, oh, I'm never going to get colleagues like they are again, and that was worrying.
Yeah.
But a lot of the girls that work here are English.
Oh, right, okay.
And a few of them had only been here a really short time when I came, so they were in the same boat as I was.
And they knew how you were feeling.
Yeah, and that sort of feeling that you get scared and you don't know the paperwork and the layout's all different.
That's what I'm sort of thinking is going to be really daunting for me, you know, is sort of being, like you said, being the new girl, being in a strange environment.
It's John's job in the UK that's driven him towards emigrating.
I've been driving HGVs since the year 2000. And my cab is my apartment for the week. It's where I live all week, I sleep there. I've been doing it for 8 years. I'm going on a Monday, coming home on a Friday.
He's hoping that working in Australia will give him the time with his family he so desperately wants.
The type of job I want is to be home, if I can, every night.
To find out about his work options in Perth, he meets Dean Hewitt, a driving recruitment expert who's also from the UK.
You've sent your resume through, which is great. The licence you have, the Class 1
yeah.
or C plus E licence in the UK, is fully transferable into Australia.
So there's a much opportunities for me then, is there?
Absolutely. Converting your licence is a straightforward process with the Department of Transport. It can take maybe a week or two. And once you've got your driving licence, you should be ready to be in full-time employment.
To find work straight away, that's well, it's put my mind at ease, Arrows.
It seems like the opportunities could exist for John, but what about the all-important hours?
We specialise in more metro work, which means that you would be home of an evening. and we work with you closely to advance your skills.
Metro Work means working within a 60-mile radius of Perth city centre, so no long haul and no overnights. It's exactly the work-life balance John's been dreaming of, and it's about to get even better.
You could be expecting to earn on average 50-hour week, Monday to Friday, between $80,000 and $100,000 per year.
$80,000 to $100,000
working an average of a 50-hour week, Monday to Friday.
I'm well happy with that.
That's way beyond what John was expecting.
I mean, back in the UK, I'm on about 40 grand, mm-hmm. so that's almost, well, it's 20 grand a year more. That's ideal, that is. Absolutely.
John could increase his salary by 50% with regular hours. Will Kerry's prospects be as promising? Back at the hospital, unit manager Sandy's giving her a tour.
It's a private maternity unit here on first floor. Our ward itself is 30 beds. We deliver approximately 800 to 900 babies privately in our hospital.
Kerry's keen to know if opportunities will exist for her here.
Job prospects for you, absolutely fabulous. Brilliant. And reviewing your CV and what you can bring to the table, absolutely wonderful again. Brilliant. Great to have you on a team.
Good, that's really useful to know as well.
What type of salary would I be looking at earning?
Okay, for the level of years of experience, starting salary, base salary would be about 73,000.
That's really, really good.
That's roughly £49,000.
At the moment, back in the UK, sort of working 57 and a half hours, I would be earning about £30,000. So it's a considerable amount of money more.
Kerry could increase her salary by £20,000 working in Australia.
So if I decided in the near future to move over to Perth, would it be worth me giving you a ring?
Absolutely. Touch base either via emails or telephone call.
Brilliant. That's lovely. Thank you ever so much.
Absolute pleasure.
It's been a hugely encouraging visit for Kerry.
I feel really positive after speaking to Sandy today. I was very surprised at the increase in pay over in Australia, and I think it would make a huge difference to our decision of moving over, knowing that perhaps we could afford a nicer house and a better lifestyle.
When John and Kerry meet to compare notes, they come to a staggering realisation.
So between us, we could possibly earn £40,000 a year more.
£40 grand a year more.
What do you say to that?
You can't say nothing to that, can you?
That's shocking, isn't it?
I wasn't expecting as much as that, I've got to be honest.
So how will they vote on working in Perth?
Based on our work experience, we are voting for...
Australia.
This is my dream, Mrs. Love, to work the normal day shifts like and be home every single day, spend time with you.
John's on cloud nine. It's a better result than he could ever have hoped for. His dream could be on track.
I'm well happy, I am.
Brilliant.
Yeah, brilliant.
With such good salaries on offer, life in Australia is starting to look very promising for the Woodlands. But no amount of money will persuade Kerry to emigrate unless John can get Chloe on board. Will a taste of the Aussie lifestyle help convince her down under's where the family should be? Spending time together is something the Woodlands just don't get enough of in the UK. So to give them a taste of what Australia could offer, they're visiting Perth's iconic Cottesloe Beach. It's been described as the second best beach in the world for families. A rare day out together is a reminder of what a move is all about.
Watching Kerry and Chloe both enjoying themselves on the bikes. I haven't seen it before, because like I said, I work away a lot back home and with family time together is quite limited. But to watch them today, it's been very, very entertaining.
The Woodlands are a dog-loving family, so today they've volunteered to take rescue dog Frisbee for an afternoon walk.
Frisbee, come on in, girl. Come on in, come on in.
Seeing Mum and Dad together is having a positive effect on Chloe.
They never get time to go out and do stuff like this back in the UK, so I think the move out here would make them a lot more happy and a lot more more like they're back in love together rather than being separated all the time.
A local pub gives the family the chance to consider what Australia could offer.
To do something like this every weekend, it'd be nice. Especially spend a lot more time with yourself.
Yeah. It does make you realise, doesn't it, where else there could be to life rather than just sort of work and the house and TV.
And John's pleased with the effect the day's had on Chloe.
The more she has the time over here, the more that she realises that Australia could offer a lot more than what where we live does. I think she's coming around to the idea.
At the beginning of the week, I was quite scared just because I didn't know what there was to do. But today have given me, well, opened my eyes really to see what you can do in Australia and that you don't have to pay a thing to do it really. I don't think there's any time of today where none of us didn't have a smile on our face.
Dream come true, really. Cheers for a good day.
Cheers.
But time out has also made Kerry realise just how big a decision the family are facing.
It's just a shame that if you did move over you, it would just be the three of us. It wouldn't be that you'd have your family there or the people that you would normally spend days with.
True enough.
Based on lifestyle, though, would the family choose Australia or the UK?
Based on our lifestyle activity today, we are voting for... Australia.
I enjoyed today. I think it was lovely to spend, you know, time doing something different, enjoying the weather and enjoying each other's company.
I enjoyed watching you enjoy yourself, I did. Watching on the bicycle.
A full house for the Aussie lifestyle has taken John another step closer to his dream. But as a reality, it could be out of reach. John and Kerry need to work out if they could afford to live down under. They'd rent out their UK home and think they could get a minimum of £400 a month to help with expenses in Oz. But will two local estate agents agree with that figure?
Seems so weird, doesn't it?
It's absolutely massive.
It's clear to see that the property is very well presented. It's tastefully decorated through the lounge and dining area. It's a good size. It's all double glazed and obviously in line with what people are looking for these days.
Oh,
yeah, it's a nice cosy dining area, leading through into the kitchen and nice patio doors through up to outside. Very good, very good.
This kitchen is a very good size again. They've done a nice finish in the high gloss units which we see, and again with the brick ceramic tile splashbacks.
Doesn't look too bad, that doesn't it?
No, it's really nice.
Oh yeah, good sized bathroom. Nice to see a separate shower enclosure, which is also very handy for a family home. Good sized double room, very feminine, pretty obviously.
This really is a fantastically sized bedroom. With the fitted wardrobe at the end is obviously an added incentive to the room as well. But it's a great sized room, a real selling point to the house.
In the current market conditions, this house should sell for in the region of 75,000. For a quick sale, I would expect 67.5. However, if they were prepared to put it on the rental market, I'd expect to achieve about £425 per calendar month.
In the current market conditions, I would value this property at £75,000. For a quick sale, I would value it at £69,950. Yeah. And for the rental market, I would hope to achieve in the region of £450 per calendar month.
Better.
Happy with that?
And happy with the rental?
£450 a month, yeah. I'm happy with that.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
It's a good result, but what about the cost of living in Perth? We've prepared a summary of their expenses so the couple can compare their finances at home with those in Australia. First up is the weekly food shop.
Okay, let's have a little look.
Potatoes.
£8.40 difference. Compared to £3 in the UK. For a 5 kilo bag, that's really expensive.
Yeah. Coffee, £1.84, £5.71.
That would make a huge difference because I drink loads of coffee.
You do.
Yeah.
Everything does seem to be a lot more dear in Australia.
The problem we got over here is you'll be home more. So you'll be eating more. £49.32 a week.
Worse off. It's £200 a month more.
Yeah. It's almost half, isn't it? It's 50% more.
And that's just the food bill. What about the bigger outgoings, such as property rental down under?
We'll look at the figures for the house number 3, the house that we all liked.
For rental.
Yeah.
Okay.
Back in the UK, the couple pay £200 a month on their mortgage.
The rent over here would be £1,667, but again, that would be on the nicer house.
Yeah.
That's almost £1,500 more per month to rent in Perth, and that's before any other household utilities. Is the dream suddenly beyond their grasp?
Obviously, that's a huge jump, and it just makes you wonder if, when you had, you know, add all the figures up and do the comparison and the what's left, really, if that's going to make a huge difference.
But with potential earnings of up to £40,000 more in Australia, could Kerry be in for a pleasant surprise?
So £921 a month better off in Australia.
And that's the most expensive.
And that's with the most expensive house.
Yeah.
Shocking.
Result there, isn't
it? That's brilliant.
And the all important bottom line?
£11,052 a year
better off.
That's good, that is.
There you go. Brilliant.
Oh man, Gary, I could be home every single day of the week.
Yeah.
And 11 grand a year being better off for it as well. Well chuffed with what I am, love.
Yeah, it makes a huge difference.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
This could be the easiest decision of the week for the Woodlands.
Based on our cost of living, we are voting for...
Australia!
And we would be silly not to, because the figures speak for themselves.
Being home every day as well, exactly. Which is a bonus, and a nice house.
Australia could mean more time together for the Woodlands, but with John's dream within touching distance, the family have yet to face their biggest hurdle. As they settle down to watch a DVD of messages from home, will the reality of leaving loved ones behind prove too much to bear for Chloe and Kerry?
Hiya John, hiya Kerry, hiya Chloe.
Right, Chloe, Kerry and John, missing you loads.
My relationship with Kerry is, we're best friends, we can tell each other anything. She's very supportive.
Soul of the party, really, John, yeah.
He's not just a cousin, he's also our friend as well.
Yeah.
And a good friend, close friend.
I think as a couple, they love each other a lot.
I love being in a relationship with Chloe. You know, she makes me feel really happy. You know, she's really fun to be with. We always have a laugh.
Bit of a shock, really. I suppose you don't really expect your children to up and go to the other side of the world. But at the same point, I'm happy for her, for the three of them.
Oh, poor Nan.
If Chloe moved to Australia, I'd miss her loads. I'd be thinking about her all the time, really.
I'd be gutted, I would.
That's nice,
isn't it? I think over the last few years, we've just got a really close bond, and I would miss her. Sorry.
Whatever decision you make, it will be a right one, and we will miss you lots.
As I keep telling you, this is an opportunity of a lifetime. You have to take it. Grasp it with both hands and enjoy it. Bye.
I hope you don't want to be without me, but you've got to do what makes you happy. I love you loads, and I'll see you soon.
Make your decision. Either stay or come back to us. Love you lots, ma'am.
Don't realise they take things for granted on your own, like.
No, Nan's the one that made me cry.
It makes you realise, doesn't it, everybody that you're going to be leaving behind, and, you know, how much they're going to miss you, not just how much you're going to miss them.
Leaving loved ones behind has always been Chloe and Kerry's biggest concern about a move down under. As their trial week draws to an end, it's now time for some serious thinking before the family make their final decision. John's had 1 week to convince daughter Chloe to buy into his dream family life in Australia. The week started well, with everyone falling for an Aussie property.
Yeah, this is what I've had in mind, Kerry.
This would be living the dream, wouldn't it?
It would be.
I really like this house.
Yes.
Oh,
positive news for Kerry and John on the job front showed just how much they could gain down under.
Kerry, I could be home every single day of the week.
Yeah.
And 11 grand a year being better off for it as well.
Chloe seemed won over by a day sampling Australia's outdoor lifestyle.
I don't think there's any time of today where none of us didn't have a smile on our face.
But messages from loved ones at home proved hard for everyone to watch.
It's just a shame that if you did move over here, it would just be the three of us. It wouldn't be that you'd have your family there or the people that you would normally spend days with.
To leave all you've got to leave back home with the normality of life back home, what you're used to and all that, would be a big choice and decision for us to make. But I believe that we could make it over here.
Coming to Perth has really been quite a good experience for myself because I can see outside of my chip shop where I work and actually see what else there is in the world and whatever type of job opportunity I could actually have.
I feel a little bit more confident that we probably could make a go with it out here. However, I think just sort of being sort of brave enough really to leave everything that you know behind, for me, you know, is still giving me big doubts really of whether I'm strong enough to do that as a person.
But could the new life Australia might offer be worth sacrificing everything the family would be leaving behind in Wales?
Now I have seen my mum and dad's relationship become a lot more closer. They seem to be a lot more, as you'd say, loved up.
It's been lovely having John home every day or being with us every day and doing things together as a family.
If we decide to stay or go, I think the biggest thing is that I'd like to spend more time with my wife and my daughter. I do dream of walking with my wife, whether it be on the beach or just in the park, or just spending time and doing just normal things with Kerry.
This week has been John's last chance to have the family life he's been dreaming of for years. So when it comes to the crucial vote, what will it be?
After an amazing week in Australia, the country that we choose to live in is... undecided.
Australia. I knew you'd choose that.
Do you? I just see I need a little bit more time to sort of get my own thoughts together and have a good think about it.
No, I understand that, Kerry. I mean, is it the thought of leaving family and friends behind which has swayed you to be undecided?
I think that's one of the main reasons. And I also think it's fear of, you're leaving everything that you're familiar with back home.
Okay.
Yeah. How about you, Chloe? Why have you chosen Australia?
Because I just think it's going to be a better lifestyle altogether.
I thought you'd be the one being undecided, not your mum.
No. And I can see all the points that you've made. They're all valid points. I just think that it just needs a little bit more deciding for me.
It's been a week to remember for the Woodlands. Chloe's finally come round to her dad's idea of a future together in Australia, but Kerry's not 100% on board. John's dream of a fresh start may be on hold for now, but who knows? The Woodlands could yet be packing for a new life on the other side of the world.